Hi everyone. People have been asking me what round food is, so I thought I'd take some time here and show you what it is. And what we're going to start out with first is super round food. And that would be something like a tangerine, an onion, pepper, tomatoes, pears, mangoes, pomegranates, avocados. As you can see, they're very round and they grew on a tree or a vine or in the ground. So that's how you tell a super round food from a not super round food. The next round food is sliced round food, which could be a zucchini, a banana. And what makes it sliced round is if you slice it from its natural grown state, it will be in a circle. And as you can see, this is from a carrot. So that's sliced round food, all very, very healthy. The next one is animal round food. And we start off with an egg, which is very round, which comes from a chicken, which is very round, and so are turkeys and pheasants, sheep, cows, all very round. And also, so many people always ask me, fish. Fish isn't round. Well, they're very curvy. They lay round eggs. And if you look at the meat of a fish, it's often in a striation, like in salmon or swordfish. So that's where that comes from. The next one is what you would eat just some of the time, and that would be shaped round food, something like a bagel. And this is a whole wheat bagel or a whole grain bagel, so the grains are round, makes us a little healthier. This is a whole wheat, whole grain, a tortilla, and cracker. So these are a little healthier if you want to eat those for the holidays or just once in a while. Then we have special round food, which I don't have any here because that would be like a pie or a cake or cookies, which you eat sometimes like at special occasions, parties, holidays, which would be right now. And then the last one is extra round, which would be something like olive oil, which you do have to be aware when you're cooking with it not to get it so that it smokes, because that makes it carcinogenic and kind of ruins its roundness. But they come from the round olive, and as you can see, round olive. And now a lot of people are telling me that they're having trouble eating round food because their parents don't eat it, so what do they do? So you can always get this in a can. A lot of people that actually may not be thinking about healthy food will buy this kind of stuff in a can. Beans in a can, all very, very healthy. And I do have, I think, at least one recipe for the beans, a chili. So chili is actually a very round dish that you can make. Now the other important thing is how much you eat, how often you eat. And I believe that a person should eat 6 times a day, about 2 to 3 hours apart. You start off with breakfast and then a snack, lunch, a snack, dinner, and a snack. And it's also important to try not to eat 3 hours before you go to bed. So these are all like little tips. They're on my site also. But for the snacks, I do 1 to 2 ounces of nuts, dried fruit, up to 20 grapes, more nuts. And you can even carry, you know, these little cutie tangerines with you as a snack. So that's all very, very important. And some other asides just before I say goodbye is chocolate covered raisins. Chocolate covered raisins are very, very round. Raisins come from the round grape, chocolate comes from the round cocoa bean. So that's, you know, kind of it can be a special treat. It also could be a little snack. Chocolate, dark chocolate is actually good for you. And so is coffee, you know, maybe up to a cup a day. They're round coffee beans. And for my last snack, if you really have a sweet tooth, is one of my favorites. I have eaten these forever. They're very addicting though, so I put them in a little dish so I don't eat too many. And that is these dried bananas. And they are sliced round. So these are just a few ideas. And if you have any comments or questions, please let me know, because I'm here to help you understand, and hopefully you will go shopping and shop just a little bit rounder so that you eat a little bit rounder and are a little less round. So bye for now.